today I'm going to be using several different eyeshadow palettes. But the first one I'm going to be using is my Morphe 35N palette. I really like this palette. I'm going to be using three shades from this, and I kind of mix them together in my crease area. I'm going to be using these two shades here along with this shade here. So it's going to be these three shades together in my... And I'm going to start off with the lightest of those three shades. You could use any shades you wanted for this. They're really just kind of like a plum shade almost. They're just kind of like a I'm not very good at explaining shades, but they have like a reddish undertone. I'm really just going, as you can kind of see the finished look over here, like a reddish look to them today. So these are just kind of very reddish, plummy eyeshadows. So anything that you have like that would work for these. But I'm just going to be going from lightest to darkest of these in my crease area and just blending them together. But I'm hoping by the time that this video is up that I have hit 100 subscribers, and if not, then I am very close at this point in time. I only am 12 away. So either way, thank you guys very much for all of the support. That is awesome to me. So yeah, I didn't expect to even get to that point. I know that there's a lot of people out there that have a lot more, so it might not seem like a lot, but to me that is a big step. So thank you very much for all of that. And I'm just going to keep blending these three shades in that crease color. We're going to be doing this a little bit of a smoky eye today. And just slowly bringing the lightest shades up closer to your brow bone. Then I'm going to go in with that darkest shade again and just bring that one more time directly into the crease. And you can be messy with this just because we have the tape here and I have not applied my face makeup yet so that I can clean up any fallout. Then I'm going in with just like a flat lid brush, and I'm going to be applying this here as a brow bone transition shade. I'm actually going to go do that over here as well because I just realized that I forgot to. Okay, then for our lid today, we're going to be using the Melt Cosmetics shadow in... what is this? Radon. This is just the very kind of orangey pink red shade. I'm not going to be applying this very intense on the lid. I really just want to use this kind of as an undertone for another shadow, but I wanted to help give it kind of that red, that brighter pop. So I'm going to be using a very fluffy lid brush to apply this. Just kind of lightly onto the lid. And again, I'm just going to be kind of messy with applying this shadow because I'm going to go in and clean it up. And I just want to apply it very lightly, so I'm just very going in very light-handed and just kind of fluffing it all over the area. And again, you can see I'm being extremely messy. You might want to not be that crazy messy with it, but it's okay because we're going to clean it up. Okay, and once you have that applied, I'm going to go in with that lightest shade that we used in our crease and apply this to the, over the top, just very lightly as well, just so that that red-orange shade kind of peeks through. Okay, and that is finished. Then when you peel off the tape, you have a nice clean line to do your wing liner. Then for our wing liner today, I'm going to be using the Made You Look Night Owl liner, and I'm going to be going in and doing the nice little, I'm not going to go too crazy with the wing, just a little precise wing. Then I'm going in with my Lights, Camera, Flashes, Tarte's mascara, and I'm going to apply these to my top lashes. Then today for lashes, I'm going in with my Coco Lashes by Coco. And now that we're done with the eyes, I'm going to move on to my face makeup. So I'm actually going to clean up this right here so I can go ahead and apply my concealer, and then I'll go in and redo the under eye part. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started on my face makeup. So first, I'm going to go in with my MAC Select Cover Up Concealer, and I'm going to be applying this under my eyes with my Beauty Blender. Now, I really need to clean all of my makeup brushes. In fact, I have got to do that today. I do not have a choice. They're terrible. I really like this concealer. I don't notice it creasing at all, and it really covers like any dark areas that you might have or any blemishes really, really well. I would say I like the coverage. It's pretty much exactly like the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye, so if you like that, you would definitely like this one. But I like this one better just because that one is so tacky that I feel like it really falls into my fine lines under my eyes. And I don't like that, whereas this one is not, so it really just smooths out the area. Then I'm also going to be using my Beauty Blender to apply my Makeup Forever HD foundation, and this is in the shade 117. And I just do two pumps, and this applies all over my face. Now, I don't normally use primers, but since this is a prom tutorial, you probably should. I didn't. I am going to set my face, though, with the Max Fix Plus. I like using that better, or like another type of setting spray than a primer, just because I feel like sometimes, I don't know if it's just like my face texture, but sometimes a primer can just make my foundation set weird on my face. So that's why I normally just don't use them, and I like the way the setting spray helps my foundation sit better. A Max Fix Plus will kind of help your blush, bronzer, and highlighter last longer. So I will use this after I apply my foundation and concealer to help set that part of my face as well, to help those last longer and stay kind of more intense and set on my face. And then I will also use it at the end to help set my entire makeup for the rest of the day. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. And since we did do since kind of an intense reddish eye look, I'm going to go for more of a natural blush today. And we are going to apply quite a bit more just because we are doing it for like an event. So you want to apply a little bit more blush just because that is kind of usually your first thing to go. But I'm going to be using the, if I can get it out, the Bliss Blush by Makeup Geek. And it's just a very natural peachy color. But if you feel like it's too much blush whenever you first apply it, it's okay because it's going to fade rather quickly throughout the night. But that Max Prep and Prime or any type of face setting spray or a primer will help make it last as well. But still, your blush is usually the first thing to go. So if you want it to last, just apply a little more and that'll help it last throughout the day. Then we're going to go in with a bronzer. I'm not going to do any contouring for this look, just because it's not something that I would normally do. You can if you want to. I'm going to kind of use my bronzer to contour, but I want to go a little bit more natural with the face, just kind of bring out the natural beauty. So that's what we're going to be doing. I'm going to be using my Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer in light bronze and a Bare Minerals Handy Kabuki brush. Now, you could definitely do a very intense contour with this look, especially since it is for an event like prom if you wanted to, but I would prefer just to do a little bit more of a natural look, especially for pictures and things like that as well. And then up here, we're going to go with the bronze. And if you have a larger forehead, especially if you're wearing your hair up and you want to make it look smaller, you can go in up here and just do this. This will help make your forehead look a little bit smaller and not so large. Also, if you're wearing your hair up, then you're just going to want to bronze this area up to make it kind of help with the natural contour of your face. Then I'm going to go in with my Artiste brush and just help blend this all in a little bit better. Then for that bronzer, we're also going to bring some of the leftover on the brush down onto our neck just to help blend everything together. Then for our highlight today, we're going to be using Mary Luminizer by The Balm. And we're just going to be using a fan brush to apply it just kind of lightly on the tops of our cheekbones. And the same with this, it's something that will kind of fade quicker, so you can apply more if you would like to. Just depends on if you want a crazy intense highlight or not. Then one more time, we're going to go in with the Max Fix Plus and just spritz that all over our face. We are going to be taking a different shadow for the bottom lash line. We're going to be taking Cocoa Bear by Makeup Geek and applying this on the outer edges of our eyes. Bring just a little bit of into the inner corner, but not as much because we're going to be adding a gold. Okay, then we're going to go in with that darkest shade from our Morphe 35N palette that we used in our crease and applying that on that direct outer corners of our eye. Then we're going in with a black eyeliner and we're going to apply that to our waterline. Okay, then we're going in with a eyeliner brush, and we're going to be taking our Kylie Bible palette, and we're going to be using this gold shade right here, and applying this on the inner parts of the bottom lash line. I'm also going to be spritzing this brush with Max Fix Plus to just help make the shadow more intense. We're also going to be applying a little bit of that shade on the inner corner just to kind of tie it to the top of the eye. And then we're going to be taking our Tarte Light Camera Lashes mascara and applying it to the bottom lash line. Hey guys, so I hope you enjoyed this video. I guess my camera stopped recording and it didn't get me recording the lip look, but I used Ofra Cosmetics Americano on my lips. I hope you guys enjoyed this prom look video that I did for you today, and if you did, be sure and hit that like button, and please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you all much so much for all of your support, and I hope to see you next Thursday and Tuesday. Bye!